this is Jean Marie Ward for Buzzy Magazine. With me today is best-selling author and musician Stephen Brust. Welcome, Stephen.
Thank you.
Drugera, the world of Vlad Taltos, has a very Eastern European flavor to it, not only in terms of the food, but also in the vocabulary. Did you also draw on the folklore of Hungary in creating this world?
I think the term stole outright would be more accurate than drew on. One of the key elements of Hungarian folklore is a shaman type, shaman sort of person called a Taltos, for instance. It's also sometimes used in an adjectival form, as in a Taltos horse or a Taltos bull.
And the Taltos drum?
That's one I don't know about.
Taltos drum.
Well, now I'm interested. Tell me.
Okay, in Wikipedia, they said that the Taltos horse was, in fact, a drum used to invoke a trance state in the shaman.
Wow, that's interesting. If you read the folktales, though, it is often, you know, the youngest of the kids turns out to be a Taltos, and he can do X, Y, and Z. Or he finds a Taltos horse, which talks to him after he feeds it, after he burns some logs down to embers and then feeds them to the horse, and then he can talk and guide the hero and so on and so forth. But I had a lot of little bits and pieces of Hungarian folklore that I threw in there. Just following my usual rule of, if it's cool, throw it in.
The cool stuff rule of literature?
The cool stuff theory of literature, yes, exactly.
Velista, the 15th book in the series, is scheduled for publication in October 2017. Has the series always followed the course you envisioned when you began?
No. When I began, I did not envision a course. I did not think there would be a course. Certainly, the first book, Jarhead, or Jarag, however you want to say it, was written as a standalone. Now, I put in a lot of foreshadowing and references to past events, because that's one of the things I like as a reader, that always makes something feel more deep. But it wasn't until I'd written three or four of them that I realized or admitted to myself I was writing a series. And once I did, I just started following the pattern of write the next story I feel like telling. Mm-hmm. So it isn't a complicated, prearranged plan of what order to reveal things in. It's just, oh yeah, I want to do that story. That sounds like fun. I think I'll do that.
Are you still planning on, I think it's 17 or 19 books?
19
books. 19 books in the series?
If I don't die first or something, then yeah, there will be 19, a first one. Set one for each house, first one called Taltos, and a last one called The Last Contract. Mm-hmm.
And getting back to Velista, though, can you give our viewers a little teaser about it?
It takes place immediately before Hawk. And I'll just say it is a truth universally acknowledged.
Oh, no. You're stealing again. Your specialty. I was about to say, will there be any shout-outs to other pieces of literature or fiction or TV shows? You just gave me one.
Maybe there might be one or two other shout-outs buried subtly in there, or else there could be a whole bunch of them that are right in your face. I don't know.
Depends on what your frame of reference is. You recently started a new series with Skylar White called The Incrementalist. How did the partnership come about?
It started when I was when I first met Sky, which was at a convention in Houston, and we started talking writing. I'm a process geek. I can talk about craft all day and all night, so could she. So we would be talking about writing and everything, and this ended up with visiting, and I would and one evening we were sitting around on her porch drinking whiskey, and she said that she has a theater background. She was a director, and she said that one of the things she missed about theater was that it was collaborative. You could, you know, work with other people to see what they do with this thing you're creating, and which is, you know, I've written several collaborations and they've all been just a joy. So I said, you can do that with a book. And she said, can? I said, yeah. And I mentioned this idea that I'd been given several years before by Tappan King for this group of sort of immortals who have existed as long as human history, and who are secretly working to make things better. Mm-hmm. And I mentioned that to her, and we started kicking ideas around. It was Powers Irish Whiskey, just for the record. Next thing I knew, we were running with it. You know, I went back home to Minnesota, and I can't remember if that was around the time I was moving away from Austin, which is where she lives. And I was living there at the time. But I went back to Minnesota and sent her the first section. Said, okay, it's your turn. Mm-hmm. And we just kicked it back and forth.
Did you split the point of view characters, or mm-hmm. did you collaborate in another direction?
No, it was very much a split of point of view characters. It was, you know, scene from each of, you know, I wrote Phil, she wrote Ren, and we would tell each other a story, is what we were doing. And it was just an amazing thing. The first draft took 6 months, which is amazingly fast for me. And it was just because I would get the scene done and send it to her, and she would come back with something, and I'd go, oh, I know what I can do. And it's astonishing how little choice there was in how the story itself unfolded. It was like it was predetermined. Once we kicked it off, it just had to start going that way. And went. It was really fun, an amazing experience.
Yeah, it reads that way. Could you elucidate a little bit more on this nice mafia of the incrementalists so our viewers can get a better feel?
The original idea, came from Tappan King, was that there's this small group, and we ended up with 204 of them, who are quasi-immortal. In other words, when one of them dies, another replaces him and might or might not have that same person's personality. And their object is, like, every time something bad happens in history, they try to make it a little less bad and try to encourage acts of kindness and generally try to push history in a more positive direction.
MP3s.
Yeah, and then they will, you know, periodically get ideas for technology that would be useful. Mm-hmm. And they'll try to slip, you know, hints of history and archaeology that it would be good for people to know, sort of point them in the right direction. You know, occasionally they'll screw up, mm-hmm. do something horribly wrong, but overall they have a positive effect.
Yeah, but I do have one major question that is raised by all of the series that I've read of yours. Are your heroes required to have mustaches?
I'm sorry, your mouth is moving, but I'm not hearing any words. Come
on. Okay, we will take that as a given, required. With all that's going on in your writing life, when do you get the time to play music?
You know, it's funny. It's not time that's the issue. Because most of my music these days is strictly amateur. It's at parties. Friends will hang out, get together, and we'll swap some tunes. Mm-hmm. It's mostly much more that there aren't any places where I can smoke and play music anymore. And so I end up being twitchy and irritated, which takes a lot of the fun out of it.
Wow. Well, that's too bad. Obviously, that shouldn't apply with a recording studio these days, given how recording studios are set up wherever. Can we look forward to any more albums in the future?
I don't think so. I feel like the solo record I did at Rose for Iconoclasties pretty much said everything I have to say about Steve with guitar playing music. I mean, I've written a few others since then, a few more songs, but I don't really feel in it. I feel like I did that.
Okay, fair enough. There are two questions we always ask as we close up. What are you working on now?
Let's see. Right now I'm working on another collaboration with Skylar, which is something completely different and is totally weird, and I have no idea what it's going to happen or what's going to happen with it, what it's going to turn out to be. And I'm also working on a new Vlad novel, tentatively titled Solmeth. And also I'm now starting to think about the end. Think about, I'm starting to gather the threads together and look at what I've got hanging out and just sort of start working toward the last contract in a very slow and gradual way.
Okay, good. And is there anything you'd like to add?
I should mention I've got another book coming out after, I think 6 months after Ballista, mm-hmm. called Good Guys, mm-hmm. which is a standalone contemporary urban fantasy. And I have finished one, although it has not yet been. Do I have to not mention that? Because it hasn't been bought.
Well, you can say you're finishing one.
You can say you did a reading of it.
Yeah, oh, that's true, I did. I did a reading of a new Parfi novel called The Baron of Magister Valley, mm-hmm. which I am hoping to sell. And it concerns a nobleman who is falsely imprisoned and after many, many years escapes from prison to take revenge on those who imprisoned him. It has nothing
to do with
the Count of Monte
Cristo.
Why would you even suggest that?
I don't know. That wholesale stealing must have something to do with it.
Maybe that's it, yeah.
Thank you so much, Steve.
You are most welcome. Thank you.
And thank you for Buzzy Magazine.